Good morning students. In the previous class we were discussing about normalization. So I explained you what is the definition of normalization and why we are using normalization, because the main definition of normalization is to design a database and to eliminate these two things. The two things are data redundancy and anomalies. In the last class we discussed about data redundancy and I told you about how the data redundancy is occurring. I mean how the repetition of data is occurring under a table and how we can able to eliminate data redundancy. So through decomposition we can able to eliminate data redundancy. And I started explaining about the anomalies. Anomalies are nothing but the errors we are facing by updating or inserting or deleting a table or the data under a table. So there are three kinds of anomalies. As I told you, we are having three kinds of anomalies: insertion anomalies, updation anomalies, and the third one is deletion anomalies. So these are the three kinds of anomalies we are facing. So the insertion anomalies, let me explain you about insertion anomalies. Insertion anomaly is nothing but we are facing troubles or we are facing some errors while inserting a data into a database or a relational schema. So consider this example. This table is nothing but a student table. So this is a student table and the attributes we are having under the student table are student ID, student name, department, building number and room number. So in this table we are considering student ID as the primary key. Okay, so student ID is primary key. Primary key is nothing but a unique key. We can able to get back all the other data. So through student ID we can able to get the balance tuple data. Okay, so while going to insertion anomalies, we are facing trouble. I told you we are facing trouble while inserting a new data. So let me tell you, if we are having a new department in our college, so I can tell you like one new department, Triple E department. Triple E department is a newly added department in our college and the building number is 4 and the room number is 401. So I am trying to add this department name, I mean the newly added department, into this table, but we will get error. Why we are getting error? Because till now this is a newly added department and till now nobody enrolled under this particular department. I mean no students enrolled under or no student take admission under Triple E department. So this two fields, I mean these two attributes, student ID and student name, will not be available and we need to make it as null. So is it possible to make these two details as a null and can be able to insert these three details? No, because obviously we need to add the primary key. And I hope you people remember what is the main definition or what is the main thing under primary key. Primary key should not become as null. So we can't able to keep primary key as a null value, and because of this single reason we couldn't able to add the new department into this table. So here we will face insertion anomaly, because we couldn't able to add this new department into this table because there is no students, there are no students enrolled under this department, I mean this Triple E department, and we can't able to add the student ID and student name under this department. And without adding the student ID we can't able to add this particular department information under this table. So whatever our college is getting new departments, or whatever our college is getting any new kind of building numbers or some rooms we extra build, so nothing we can able to add without a student ID and student name. So here under this table this will come as an error and we will face trouble while inserting this particular data. So this kind of anomaly we are naming as insertion anomaly. So to avoid this insertion anomaly, what we can able to do, we can able to make this department as a separate table. Here also what we need to do is we need to decompose our table. So how we can able to decompose our table? We can able to create one new table, like the name of the table is department. And the attributes we can able to add department name building number and room number. And we can able to add all the department details under this particular table, like CSE, Mechanical Engineering, Fashion and Technology, and the room number of CSE is 1, and Mechanical building number is 3, room number is 301, and Fashion and Technology building number is 2, and room number is 201. So, by adding a new department detail, we can directly go and add the department detail under this table, and we don't want to add the department details under this particular student table. So here we can able to add the newly added department, I mean the AAA department. The building number is 4 and the room number is 401. So there won't get any trouble while adding this data into this table, and we can able to successfully insert the data into this one. So while decomposing this table into department another table, or while decomposing the student table into two separate tables, we don't want to add the building number, room number data into this table. We can make it as a separate one. We only want to add these three attributes under student table, like student ID, student name and department. So there won't get any trouble while adding any kind of newly added department. Okay, so this is mainly insertion anomaly. So hope you guys understand the insertion anomaly, how we are getting an insertion anomaly and how we are just eliminating insertion anomaly through decomposition. So one thing you need to remember, all of this, as I told you in the previous class, data redundancy also we can able to remove through decomposition of table. And here also, while inserting, the anomalies will get, and the insertion anomalies also we can able to avoid through decomposition of the table. Okay, so here while decomposing into separate table, there won't get any troubles by adding these kind of data. Okay, so hope you understand about insertion anomalies. Next thing I will explain you about the second type of anomaly, updation anomaly. So updation anomaly, in the sense, while getting updation or while doing updation, we will get troubles or we will get some errors. So I can tell you, our CSE department, the building number of CSE department is changed to building number 5. So what will happen? What will happen if we are just updating this particular CSE department building number to 5? We need to update again and again. I mean, here also CSE student is there, again the building number needs to update it. And if hundreds of CSE students will be there, means we need to update all those 100 student building numbers into 5. So this will get a trouble, and you will get a very large query to update all these kind of details. So here again we will get some anomalies, and that anomaly is updation anomaly. For updating a single data, we need to do multiple updations, I mean hundreds of updations. If the CSE department is having more than 500 students or nearly 1000 students, we need to update 1000 rows under this table. So it will again get troubles while updating the table. So here also we can able to avoid this particular updation anomaly through decomposition. So as I told you, for insertion anomaly, we just created one new table, or we just decompose this old table to a new table, like department also we decompose to a department table. So inside this table, if we are changing, or if we need to update the building number of CSE to 5, means only one row we need to update, and we need to change this particular row, I mean the department name of CSE, the building number of CSE we can able to change to building number 5. So only one kind of updation, or only one row of updation is required under this table, and through this we can able to remove updation anomaly. Without doing multiple updation steps, within single step we can able to update through this. So for this also, what we need to do, we need to do the decomposition of table. So through this, through decomposition of table, decomposing the department into a separate table, the within single row we can able to update any kind of detail. So again, some updations can come if the mechanical department is changing the room number to 301 to 303, means only one row we need to update. Instead of doing multiple updations under this student table, only one row we need to change under this table. So through this we can able to remove updation anomalies also. Okay, so this is the second type of anomaly. And the third type of anomaly is deletion anomaly. Okay, so let me explain you the deletion anomaly. So hope you understand the first two anomalies, insertion and updation. See here, in this table, I need to delete one student ID because that student left from the college. So this student, the student ID is 2 and the student name is J and he is under mechanical department, building number 3 and room number is 301. So I need to delete the student name, I mean this student from our college because he left from the college. What I need to do, I need to just remove this student ID with respect to the primary key. So here primary key is student ID. Obviously with the help of this primary key, I can able to easily delete this student information. So what will happen if we are deleting this student information? See here, under this table, only one student is available under mechanical department. So if I am just deleting this student information, the department, I mean the mechanical department details also will get deleted. Because some other students will be available, or the mechanical is still exist in that college. The mechanical department is still exist in that college. Because while deleting this particular student information, the department information also will get deleted. And if anybody is seeing this database from outside, what they will think? In that college, mechanical department is not available. So they will think like that. But the real scenario is what? We are having mechanical department, but nobody is enrolled under mechanical department. That is the scenario. This will face deletion anomaly. So here we will face deletion anomaly. If we are deleting any student information and with that student information, one department information is also getting deleted. So here we will face deletion anomaly. So how we can able to overcome this deletion anomaly? The same procedure we can use, decomposition of table. So with the help of the same department table, we can decompose the big table to a two small tables, like one table with student and this student is having student ID, student name and department. So what are the contents of this table? 5 students are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ajay. And second student is J. Okay, so 5 students are there and all these students are under several departments. So this student table will have the details of students with student information like student ID and name and department. And the department name, department table is having the details of department name, building number and room number. So what will happen if we decompose this big table into these two small tables? If we need to delete any student information, means we can able to delete only the student information under this student table. So what we can do, we can able to delete the student information. I need to delete the student information with student ID 2. So I can able to easily delete that student information under student table. So what is the advantage while deleting in this way? Because still the mechanical department is existed under department table. So while viewing from outside, others, I mean the outside users, can able to understand mechanical department is still available in that college. Because here we are deleting only the student information, we are not deleting the entire information. So this is the main advantage while we are decomposing the big table, or mean the large table, into two different tables. So only if we need to delete any kind of student information, we need to delete from only from the student table and not from the department table, and the department individual informations will be available under this small table. Okay, so this is the main advantages of removing, deleting or eliminating the anomalies like insertion, updation and deletion. So the main thing what we need to do while removing these anomalies, the only thing we need to do is we need to decompose the table into smaller tables, because while considering a large table, so many errors we will get, so many errors we will face. So while decomposing into small tables, we can easily identify and we can able to perform the queries in an easy manner. Okay, so hope you understand the normalization. Normalization is nothing but designing a database to eliminate these two conditions, in the sense data redundancy and data anomalies. Anomalies involves insertion anomaly, updation and deletion. So after eliminating these two things, we will find out a perfect database table. Okay, thank you.